You truly are the beloved children of God, temporarily lost within the confusing maze that is the illusion. January 3, 2014. Another year has passed and humanity still waits for the event, the awakening, the move into full consciousness, yet nothing of note seems to have occurred to indicate that you are any closer. Naturally, doubts and suspicions arise. Is it all pie in the sky, wishful thinking? Or is humanity just a biological system, for instance like a colony of ants, in which a biological drive or determinant, with no real awareness of itself, causes a flow of energy or activity that produces, through chemical interactions, a large number of different directives causing the colony to split into warring factions. Warring factions with very different but strongly held conflicting beliefs. Is life in fact meaningless, godless, pure happenstance? Many of you are experiencing doubts like this, or similar ones, and yet deep within you know that these doubts are unwarranted because you know that you truly are the beloved children of God, temporarily lost within the confusing maze that is the illusion. In your confusion, in that felt sense of aloneness, you want comfort, reassurance, love. The confusion is a powerful distraction that drives anxieties and doubts through your minds at high-speed roof brain chatter, making it very difficult for you to access the quiet inner space where you can find peace, stillness, and the certainty that you are an inseparable part of your source. And of course, the remedy for these doubts and anxieties is, as always, to go within and allow your thoughts to flow by, unattended to, as you rest in that quiet inner sanctum. Do not engage with or follow a line of thought because that defeats the purpose of going within. Be patient, and to assist yourself in remaining quiet and undisturbed, it can be helpful to repeat a short mantra, listen to some relaxing music at a low volume, or unfocus your eyes while looking at a flower, a candle, or nothing in particular. In fact, you could do all of the above. What counts is finding something that works for you, and you can ask for help with this from those in the spiritual realms with whom you feel an affinity, a favorite saint or angel, or any spiritual being you feel comfortable calling upon for help. You all have someone who you believe responds to you, and of course they do. And even if you have not called on them for a very long time, they are still there for you, waiting expectantly with willing and loving help. Call on them, they truly want to assist you. It is important to keep reminding yourselves that you really are the beloved children of God, whose love for you is infinite, constant, and uninterruptible. The illusion is an enormously distracting influence on you because it is basically a collective ego construct that desperately wants you to believe that it is real, and you must admit it does a very good job of convincing you. But the only reality is eternal, everlasting, and indestructible. Anything that decays, wears out, breaks down, crumbles, disintegrates, or just fades away with time is unreal. So, yes, your bodies are unreal, but you are not, you are eternal beings just like your heavenly Father. There is no death. Life is eternal. What you experience as death is just a laying down of the body that has served you during your excursion into the illusion and that you no longer need or have a use for. You move on, leaving it to return to the dust from which it was constructed, now that its purpose has been fulfilled. Do not mourn it, because without your enlivening presence it is nothing, inanimate material in an illusory and non-existent environment. An environment that you collectively built and maintain. Humanity has made the decision to awaken, consequently the pillars, the foundations, the underpinnings that support the illusion are crumbling and disintegrating. In terms of geological time, those seemingly endless eons since the Big Bang, and even before it, the crumbling and disintegration appears very slow, like, as you might choose to describe it, watching paint dry, or, a little more realistically, bearing in mind that within the illusion nothing is real, watching rocks wear away beneath the waterfall. However, the illusion lasted but an instant, a brief indeterminate moment while you entertained the thought of the unthinkable, separation from your source. Separation from your source, God, your heavenly Father, is utterly impossible, as you have so often been told, and the thought of such an impossible situation could not and did not last. Nevertheless, you, humanity, is seemingly experiencing a state of separation so dire that awareness, knowingness, the ever-warming divine embrace in which creation is eternally enfolded, does not appear to be enfolding you. And you see all around you conflict, mistrust, and betrayal that seems to confirm this unhappy experience. Remind yourselves yet again that you are divine beings, utterly inseparable from God, and that you are to awaken into the brilliant, infinitely loving light of eternal day, where perfect peace and harmony of a nature completely beyond your ability to conceive of, have you unfolded in a state of permanent and ecstatic bliss. It is time to release your tight hold on the illusion, after all the decision to do so has already been made, and allow yourselves to awaken to a resounding and magnificent welcome from all in the spiritual realms. Your loving brother, Jesus. Channeled by John Smallman. JohnSmallman2.wordpress.com.